here are some assumptions that I make about you based on your reading habits. If you read books in a position resembling a hard shell taco in order to avoid cracking the spine, you probably own boat shoes. If you use a legitimate bookmark every time you read a book, you probably frequently use the term low pony. If you consistently and or by preference read sitting in a chair, you probably at one point in time thought you were going to be a vet. And lastly, if you organize your bookshelf by height from tallest to shortest specifically, you believe in ghosts.
I've just realized a reading habit that I have, and I don't know if this is a common thing, so I'm going to tell you about it, and you have to tell me if you do this too in the comments, please, so I'm not alone. I am so nearly done with this book. I'm so close to the end, and I'm enjoying it. Probably about a 4-star read. I'll give it a review when I have done. And I'm intrigued about what's going to happen. There's nothing in me that doesn't want to finish this book, basically. And yet, for some reason, I'm just procrastinating the ending. I just keep doing everything I can to avoid reading the last 20 or so pages of this book for some reason. Like, why? And it's not especially because I don't want it to end. Like, I'm very excited about what I'm gonna read next. It's not like the best book I've ever read, like I'm not gonna miss it. So like, what's happening to me? And I've realized I actually do this semi-often. Like, I often procrastinate the ending of a book, whether I'm enjoying it or not. Do you do this, and do you have a theory as to why?
That's not normal. And I think, you know, you should maybe get some help or something.
Just one book at a time. If you have a hard time maintaining a reading habit, it might be because you're just getting stuck on books that you're bored with. I like to have at least 4 going at any time. 1 easier fiction, 1 harder fiction, an easier nonfiction, and a harder nonfiction. With a few books going in different styles and difficulties, you'll always have something for whatever mood you're in and be way less likely to get bored and fall out of the habit entirely.
You can't have that cookie, Elmo! Rocco wants to eat it!
How is Rocco gonna eat that cookie, Zoe? Tell Elmo! Rocco doesn't even have a mouth! Rocco's just a rock! Rocco's not alive!
I can't see, I'm blind.
This is a Put a Finger Down Challenge Lawful Good Reader Edition. Put a finger down if you use a real bookmark. Put a finger down if you stick to a TBR list. Put a finger down if you only read one book at a time. Put a finger down if you have some particular method of preparing a paperback to read so that you don't crack the spine. Put a finger down if you only stop reading when you're at the end of a chapter. Put a finger down if you look up pronunciations or definitions of words in a book that you're reading you don't know. Put a finger down if you read every book you buy. Put a finger down if you have a really specific system for organizing books on your shelf that you stick to no matter what. Put a finger down if you never skip ahead in a book to see what's coming. And finally, put a finger down if you will patiently wait to buy a new book until it comes out in a paperback or whatever matches the rest of the series. If you put at least 5 fingers down, you're a lawful good reader.
A thousand times, I've got no roots, but my home was never on the ground. I've got no roots, but my home was never on the ground. I've got no roots, I've got no roots.
And they divided us into 5 groups, factions, to keep the peace. The smart ones, the ones who value knowledge and logic, are an erudite. They know everything. Amity farm the land. They're all about kindness and harmony, always happy. Candor value honesty and order. They tell the truth, even when you wish they wouldn't. And then there's Dauntless. They're our protectors, our soldiers, our police. I always thought they were amazing. Brave, fearless, and free. My faction is abnegation. The others all call us stiffs. We lead a simple life, selfless, dedicated to helping others.
Do you have any weird reading habits? Like things where you're like, Does everyone do this or is it just me?
I'm a really expressive person already. So when I read books, I find that I physically make the expressions and the noises that the characters do. When it's like, she let out a breath she didn't know she was holding, I'll literally be like,
or she sighed softly.
Or if the author's describing facial expressions, like their eyes went really big or their mouth hung open, I literally find myself mimicking those actions. Does anyone else do this or is it just me?
If somebody had a gun to my head and said, spell croissants, I'd be dead.